In this lecture, we will learn about three aspects of Python: variables, data types, and literals. After this lecture, you will be able to define variables, define data types, define literals and its various types. So let's first look into variables. In the previous lecture, we have learned that a variable is an identifier. It represents a memory area, and that memory area is used for storing a value. So here you see there is a memory area that is created. Inside this memory area, a value 10 is stored, and this memory area is represented by an identifier called as A. That is why A is a variable. Same applies to this variable here. A memory area is created in which there is a string or a sequence of characters that are stored, and S is representing that memory area, or S is referring to that memory area. That is why S is also a variable. If I want to create such a memory area, okay, or if I want to create a variable, then in Python we are going to use an assignment operator for doing so. So for creating such a scenario that you see here, I'm going to write something like A equal to 10. When I do that, 10 is created in memory and A starts referring to it. Okay. In simple terms, we say that 10 is assigned to A. That is why this operator is called as an assignment operator. The second scenario that you just saw here is created by saying S equal to hello. So hello is created and is assigned to S, or S refers to hello. Similarly, you will see that in B, we have a value stored called as false, and in X, we have a value stored called as 10.2. Now, the kind of values that you see here are of various types. So first one is an integer number. The second one is a sequence of characters. That is why it is called as a string. The third one here can have a value like false or true. That is a purpose of doing so. And therefore, this is called as Boolean. Boolean values are having only two possible values, either true or false. And the last one is where I am storing a decimal number. In programming terms, we call them as float values. So these are different types of values that you are going to study and see in Python. Now, to understand how these values are created and how variables refer to them, there is a very useful function that we can use called as an ID function. ID function returns the identity of an object. Now, what is an identity? It is a unique number identifying a specific value. Okay, so these specific value, you can also call them as objects in memory. So you see here, there is a specific value created. Value stored is 10 here, and there are two variables referring to it, n and k. This is due to me writing in Python n equal to 10 followed by k equal to 10. Okay, now understand that 10 will not be created twice in memory. It will be created only once, and both n and k will be referring to the same memory area. Now, how I am so sure about this? The reason is because this memory area that I have created here will also get an identity, a unique number specifying it. So let's go to Python shell and study this. So here, the very first statement is n equal to 10. So let me type that. Okay. Now I want to know what is the ID associated with that 10. So for that, I will use an ID function and I will write here n. When I press an enter key, I get some unique identifier or unique number representing that value n. After that, let's create k equal to 10. Okay. So when I do that, and when I again type ID k, this time I want to know the ID of k, okay, and then press an enter key, you will see that ID of k and ID of n both are giving me the same value. So the value that you get here, the unique number that you get here, indicates that both n and k are referring to the same memory area that is holding value 10. Now, these values that we create, they are immutable. That means I cannot change them. Though I say that num is a variable. So, something is a variable means I can change its value. But then, when values are created, they are immutable. That means I cannot change them. Okay. So, how that happens and how then the variables are created, let's study that. So, here you'll see a first statement num equal to 10. Now, we understand that when I write num equal to 10, this is what will be the scenario. Okay. Let's look at the next statement. Now, I have said k equal to num. So, then k also should hold the same value as what num is. When I write k equal to num, it means num value is assigned to k. The scenario will be something like this. Okay. So, both k and num are holding a value 10. And therefore, num and k are both referring to this value 10. Okay. Let's look at the next statement. So, now what I have done is I have changed the value of num. So, now I am saying num equal to 20. Okay. So, that does not mean that this memory area is changed to 20. There is a new memory area created with value 20 and num starts referring to it. So, now you will see both k and num are referring to two different values. Okay. That is a meaning of immutability. That means this memory area which is holding a value 10 is immutable. I cannot change it. Okay. So, if I change the value of a variable by using an assignment operator, there is a new memory area created with that new value stored inside it. Okay. So, here in the program, num is a variable because its value is changing. Here it is num equal to 10 and here it is num equal to 20. But inside implementation is that these values are unchangeable or immutable. Now, it is possible to do multiple assignments in a single Python statement. Okay, so, there are two examples that you see here. One is x, y, z equal to, and then after equal to, I have to provide a value for x, then provide a value for y, and then provide the value for z. Okay, so x gets the value as 12, y gets the value as 3.4, and z gets the value as true. If I want to assign same value to multiple variables, then I can use assignment operator like this in cascading. And 12.67 will be assigned to z, value of z will be assigned to y, value of y will be assigned to x. This is how all x, y, and z get the same value, 12.67. So, you can try this in Python shell. You can say x, y, z equal to, let's say 10. Okay, I want to give the second one as some string value. So, I say hello and then I say value true. That is Boolean value. Okay, and now if I type x, it will get 10. I type y, it will get a value hello. I type z, it should get a value as true. Okay. Similarly, you can say x equal to y equal to z equal to 12.67 or any other value that you wish to assign. And you can again see what is the value of x, y and z. All three of them get the same value. Okay, so now in the previous few slides, we have seen that we are storing different types of values inside variables. Okay, so what type of value I am storing, define what is its data type. So, if in Python shell, if I type in n equal to 10, I am storing 10 inside n. So, that means data type of n is integer. Okay. Now, why is this data type important? Because the type of data decides various things. The first thing that it decides is that what is the range of possible values that I can hold. So, if I am saying that some variable is an integer, that means it can hold only integer type of values. Okay. Then second is, what is the amount of storage required? So, amount of storage required for integer is quite different from amount of storage that would be required for a string. Okay. So, storage in RAM or in memory. And what are the possible operations that I can perform on that variable? So, if a variable is an integer, then I can add two integers. Whereas, if a variable is a Boolean, which can hold only true and false, then I cannot add two Boolean variables. Okay. So, operations that I can perform on a variable is also decided by its data type. Okay, so let's learn about how to find a data type. So if I here in Python shell, I have typed n equal to 10. And let's now say type of n. So there is a function available in Python called as type, which you can utilize for finding the type. So it says type of n is class int. Okay, it indicates that data type of n is integer. Now I say n is 12.56. Okay, this time the data type is float. So therefore, I now say n and says the value is float. Okay, next let's store some string inside it. Okay, and now I try say type and then n and say string. Okay, now let's keep some boolean value. So I say n equal to true and then again I say type n. Okay, it says class bool. Okay, so that means the data type of n is now bool. As compared to other programming languages, in Python, we do not fix up a data type for a variable. A variable's data type is decided by what type of value I'm storing in that. Okay, so here you will see that when I was storing 10 in n, type of n becomes integer. I change the value type as float. And the same variable n, which is now having the type as float. Okay, so depending upon what type of value I'm storing, it is decided what is the data type of a variable. Let's look at what are literals. It is a sequence of one or more characters that stands for itself. Okay, what that means is that when I have said here, when I have said n equal to 10, this 10 that you see is a literal, n is a variable. Okay, so it is a sequence of characters 1 followed by 0 that means for itself, that means 10. Okay, similarly here this hello that I have given in single quote is a literal, 12.56 is a literal, true is a literal. Okay, so based on, because we have various data types, that is a reason why we also have various types of literals. So we have numeric literals, okay, which are numbers. Now numbers can be integers or numbers can be floating point values. You can also use a plus and a minus sign for indicating negative values and positive values. This you can do with float also. So if 7.8 I write, I can write it as plus 7.8 to mean positive 7.8, and if I want to write minus 7.8, that also I can do. When I write a floating point literal, you will see there are various forms. Okay, you can also write a floating point literal as 0.96. Okay, that would mean 0.96. And similarly here, I can write it as 89 point instead of writing 89.0. Now, these notations that you see here are decimal notations. You can also write a floating point or a real number like this. You can write it as 1.26. Write a character E followed by a sign, plus or minus, and followed by a number. Okay, so what this whole thing means is this is a number 1.26 into 10 raised to plus 30. Okay, so E stands for multiplied by 10 raised to 30. So if you write a decimal number like this, it is called as a scientific notation. Then we have string literals. String literals are sequence of characters that you enclose either in single quote or enclose them in double quotes. Okay, you can choose any one of them. There is no difference in that. And then finally, we have Boolean literals. Boolean literals can hold only two types of values, either true or false. Note that this T and F has to be capital. We stop here.